In this video, I will explain double and add algorithm for elliptic curves. Given a point P on elliptic curve, you have to find NP. Where N is an integer and P is point on the elliptic curve. A naive algorithm will work like that. You will first compute 2p using point doubling algorithm. 2p will be equals to p plus p. Then you will compute 3p which will be equals to p plus 2p and so on. At the end you will compute np which will be equals to p plus n minus 1p. So in total you have done n minus 1 point doubling and point addition operations. Let's compute the time complexity of this naive algorithm. And the time complexity is computed based upon the size of input. And size of input is not n, it is the number of bits required to express n. So we can say the size of input is m, where m is equals to log base 2 n. So now we have to express our number of operations with respect to the size of input. We know the number of operations are n minus 1. So in terms of m, we can write that number of operations are two raised to power m minus 1. And if you compute this, it will be n minus 1. So in terms of big O, the time complexity is 2 raised to power m. And this is an exponential time complexity. And we all know the exponential time complexity is not good because the growth rate is very fast. But luckily we can do better than that due to the double and add algorithm. The double and add algorithm computes np in polynomial time. Let me explain double and add algorithm using an example. In this example, I'm asked to find 26p. I will first write 26 in terms of binary. Where this is the most significant bit and this is the least significant bit. I will scan my bits from most significant to the least significant bit. I will first start from the first bit, which is 1, and I will always ignore the first bit. So I still have P, as the second bit is also 1. And if the bit is 1, then I will perform two operations. One is point doubling and the other one is point addition. So I will perform double. Double will make p into 2p. Then I will do point addition. Addition implies that I will add p in the result. So 2p plus p is 3p. The next bit is 0. And in case of 0, I will only do the point doubling operation. And 3p is doubled to 6p. The next bit is 1. So I will once again perform two operations. First double, I will have 12p. Then I will do addition operation. 12p plus p is equals to 13p. and the last bit is 0. For 0, I will only perform a point doubling operation. And voila, I have 26p. So now let's compute the time complexity of this new algorithm. So in this case, a number of steps are proportional to the size of input. In this case, we have size of input was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the number of steps are also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have basically 5 steps. In each step, we can have at most 2 operations. So in the worst case, we can say we have 2 M operations. And in terms of big O, the time complexity is big O M. And this is linear time complexity, and we all know that linear is good. So we have achieved linear time complexity in place of exponential time complexity.